Barriers are like brick walls that tend to stop us from achieving our dreams. But once they are conquered, the sky almost becomes the limit. Welcome to another edition of Breaking Barriers. My guest today is a young man who has carved a niche for himself by hard work, creativity, and ingenuity. He's a man of many parts, an artist, a musician, and a photographer. His name is Yomi Matthew Wonderful. Yomi, you are welcome to Breaking Barriers.
Good morning, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
All right. Well, the challenge is knowing what to really point out, whether it's your music, whether it's your photography, or whether it's your production. And
I'll be glad just to
just
pick
before we
anywhere,
came
just
to the
anywhere
studio,
to speak.
somebody also described you as a pastor. So, you seem to be into many things. Who exactly is Yomi Matthew?
Wow, this is the same question a lot of people have asked me in time past. That, you know, what aspect of this production are you, or of life, are you really good at that I do? But myself, I don't know what I do most. I don't even know what I really love the most, because I do everything to the capacity I really love the most. But, you know, when I hit on graphics, when I'm facing graphics again, I do excellent work out of it. When I face photography, I do something good out of it. And when I face music as well, music production, even singing. In fact, I see correct musicians during their production. So I don't really know what I do. But like I said, like the Bible said, that the path of the righteous shineth brighter and brighter. I think everything I do is bright and very much okay for me, for my own part.
It seemed your parents had the foreknowledge of what you were going to become, and they added Wonderful to your name.
Actually, the name Wonderful was added by myself. Yeah, when I knew what I was going to, as in what I was up to inside of me now, I was like, this boy, you're just wonderful. You know, these wonders have not really appeared. But me, I knew what I was up to. I think I was around my GSS3 after my junior WAEC, my junior WAEC. So I added the name to my name in my SS1.
And it stuck
Yeah, stopped. I make
Today.
sure it's reflected in all my documents.
And it's actually the definition of your life.
Yeah, so
Yomi Matthew
wonderful.
Wonderful.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's go to your background. When you were born, where you were born, and how life was as a young Nigerian.
Yeah, I was born into a Christian family. My dad is a pastor. My mom is a prophetess. A pastor that serves, this work of God. In the olden days, pastors are the ones, are the most, they suffer a lot. Things doesn't go rosy. It's not for now. With that is about 30 something years ago. I think I'm about 30 plus. So and I was born in Ilorin, Kwara State. And that was where my parents was before they were later transferred to Kaba. So and I think I spent a lot of my years in Kaba. In Kaba, a lot of my years. Yeah. Because I think I was around 5 years plus when we arrived Kaba, and I've been in Kaba since then.
What was growing up like for you? Was
Mm.
it an easy life? Was it challenging?
Like I said, a pastor's family, serving under a pastor, a founder, it's not a rosy life at all, because it's not easy as a pastor's son, as a pastor. Talk more of even the son. So I don't want to. I know people that are watching now understand what I'm talking about. So I don't want
We understand.
those who are from pastor family about 30 something years ago, we understand.
That experience, did it in any way shape you into becoming who you are? Maybe the challenges you went through,
My parents went through that.
yes, your
Of
parents went
course,
through.
of course, of course, of course. As we were growing up, seeing my parents, my father as a pastor, couldn't even afford our 3 square meals in a day, because the salary it takes from the church is so minute that paying house rents. So many times, different people come to to the house to harass us for payment of some things or the other. I just decided and said that, come on, like this I go today. I'm being the first born of four. I didn't talk about that. We are four, and four of us are male. Being the first born, I knew that I need to buckle up and get something to do. And from there, I've been interested in having something to do by myself. I never for one day dreamed that I'll be working under a government sector or whatever. I just believe that I'm going to do something by myself. And that is, this, all these horrible experiences made me as in to decide on whatever I'm doing today.
Okay. When you come from a background like your own, where your parents are pastor, your father a pastor, your mother a prophetess, it's like a double-edged sword. Most times, parents like that tend to push their children into the same line they are doing. Did you have that challenge
of
parents saying, you must become a pastor just like us?
Of course. Up to now, the pressure is still mounted on me.
Oh.
But you know, the understanding I have, you know, as I was growing up, apart from being a Christian, I went to school. I think I went to Kogi State University and studied philosophy. Now my mind changed, you know, the way I reasoned changed. And I know that, come on, it's not by force you become pastor. Not be waiting your father to do, you must do by force. No. No, I was still in the field of media, but I was still thinking I will still become a pastor or whatever. But later I just got to know that, come, the influence of my parents is nothing on me. As in, I don't have to bow to that pressure of becoming, because normal in a pastorship stuff, it's not by inheritance, it's by calling. So I have not received any call for now.
Okay.
So I don't have, okay. But my parents want me to receive their own call, to use their call. I say no, for now.
Okay.
No call.
Okay. Well, he may not be a pastor, but he's doing some things related to the work of God. When we come back after this break, I will ask Yomi questions related to that and how he got into music and production. Stay tuned. We'll be back very shortly.
By continuing to run toward my dream. Don't stop running toward your dream.
Harsh winds of life blowing against you, and did you think all hope was lost? Breaking barriers, inspiring stories of incredible breakthrough.
I had told myself that I would never let the past destroy my future, you know, and that's one thing I had in mind, that no matter what it costs, I will get where I want to go.
From hopelessness to fulfillment, from the valley to the mountaintop, from grass to grace, where there is a will, there is a way.
I believe in positive brainwash. When you get used to think positive thoughts, it becomes your default state of mind. This is why I love to hear about success stories. It motivates me and gives me hope. If others did it, I can do it too.
The program is still Breaking Barriers, and with me in the studio is Yomi Matthew Wonderful. Yomi, before we went on break, we were talking about your music, the production, photography, editing, and all of that. Which one came first?
I think what came first was music. Not music per se, instrumentation. You know, as a pastor's child, one of the advantage of every pastor's son is access to church instruments. You know that? For those who are interested and having interest in that. So I was able to grow up as a church, you know, first as a drummer boy. No, you are like Bamole now. That's what I started with. So when I was playing the drum, from there migrated to drums, said drum. From there migrated to keyboard. And I think that's where the, you know, coordinating the choir. These are the assets we had, and before you know it, we're able to have interest in music production. Alongside, you know, the church, as a pastor's son, we had a drama group at the same time. So we have drama group in the church, which I head the drama group. And from there, you know, being passionate about this, watching movies and other stuff, I said, come, we can do this thing now, let us put it together. So from instrumentation, from others, I entered into the drama again. So from drama, we now started the movie production, 2003, back in the church then. So we did the first movie, Normal Video Courage. No idea. But we know that at least there's a way this can be done. And what you know is we're encouraged by people that are, no, you are trying. Although, so many discouragement, but at least, I think we're not talking about that for now. But at least I was able to overweight whatever anyone is saying. I just have my interest. And that is how I picked it up. So between drama or music, I think both of them came together. Through instrumentation to church drama.
So what began like a disadvantage to you, being a pastor's son, with all the troubles that surrounded that calling,
yeah,
actually became an advantage
for me,
for you.
Yeah, I was catching fun with,
yes,
that. No, it didn't allow me to really have attention on the bad part of what is happening to my parents then. So all this was an advantage I wrote on. I never thought of what's the bad part of whatever is happening to my parents, so I took advantage of all this. And that is what made me to.
Okay. You took advantage and you began to break barriers.
Barriers, yeah.
Now, going into music, music production and drama production and of course movie production, I'm sure it didn't come easy for you.
Of course.
Now, tell us some of the challenges that you went through.
Well, if I'm to talk about challenges, we wouldn't live here today. But of course, there are a lot of challenges in this production field, apart from even Kaba. Anywhere. Challenges for production is always sponsor. No, we always lack sponsor for anything we do. We have to raise funds to get cameras, to film, to take people to the production feed. And then there was a time, 2010 or so, 9 or 10, we released a movie, Gbekun, Bandage. We had to go for about 7 days at Gbeleko village, for almost 7 days with all the members. So, you know, feeding them morning, afternoon, night. We're there. And you know what it is to, you know, to bring people. At the end of the day, so many people now, they want you to, you know, after going for acting, they expected that when the movie is released, this guy has gotten money, supposed to pay us. Whereas some of this money itself was borrowed, that we're still having standings to pay. There was a time, me and my friend, we went to borrow money from a cooperative society to make a mass dubbing back then. Now, at the end of the day, we did the launching. We are not able to make, in fact, we didn't even make 10% of what we put into the production.
Yeah.
So they said that the people, the cooperative people, were now chasing us up around, you know, in the town. All these are just challenges, you know, getting equipment later, you know. But we were able to stop by that. Every year, when I was in production in the field, we make sure that despite all the challenges, every year we push up to still produce something the next year. We never said because there was no gain last year, there was discouragement, there was no support, then we cannot do something better. So we have to stop and we still fire on.
Well, sometimes when we are faced with challenges, the only thing that propels us is the dream before us. What were the big dreams that pushed you on in spite of the challenges?
The big dream that
Pushed you on?
The big dream that pushed me on was just this, you know, was just my dream. The big dream that pushed me on was still my dream. You know, it is good in anything you do in life to have plans for yourself. You know, I had plans already, right from my secondary school days, when I changed my name to Wonderful. Before I did it, I didn't just do it. I had plans that, okay, how is the future going to look like? I see myself having this, having that, having those. No. And everything that I put in plan, I'm not distracted. I know what I'm going to do. There was a day when my friends came in and saw my studio now, saw the name, Home Studios, you know, the way it's branded now. And I said, do you remember what you told us some times back, that you said you have a studio that is on upstairs, that there will be, it will be branded Vogue Music House. It was even Vogue Music House. He said, I told him then. I can't even remember, but I knew it is part of my plan that, okay, this is what I'm going to have. And everything is working towards. So that is the big dream that keep my dream.
Okay.
Moving on.
Now, let's talk about that aspect of music. You started from the church, of course, at a very small level.
Yeah, well, yeah.
How did you grow up to becoming a producer with a studio that is the talk of the town?
Yeah, it's just by training.
Okay.
Training, learning more, getting more knowledge, acquiring more skills. I think that's just what really helped me out, because, you know, until I even started a studio, I've never been to any standard studio before in Lagos. But I watch YouTube, I watch videos, and I read books, because then there was no much access to internet. But at least I watch and I listen to music, so from there I was able to catch up.
Okay. How has the journey been so far for you in terms of production and the feedback you get from your work?
Of course, nice. Okay, you know, It's getting good now. That, in fact, before I came into the studio, you can see someone came to meet me for something, and it was on music as well. Mm. People are now dropping in from different parts of the state, not even only Kogi State now, for music production. So it has been cool. It has been cool.
Okay. You are into music, into photography, and other stuff. But which one pays the bill?
Well, I don't want to say the one that pays the bill on time.
Okay, you will tell me later.
Yeah, I will tell you what the one that pays the bill.
All right.
Because okay. I do a jack of, as in I do a sort of things. Okay. And to raise funds, you know,
yeah.
Some of these things are not really giving money now. Mm. Some of the things I do now.
Okay.
But at least there's a way I make my money as well.
Okay.
Because one thing, if you are into media, you can never be broke. That's just that's just the beauty. Mm. If you know, you know, I don't want to say how I make food anyway. Okay. But it's not really easy for me.
Okay. Okay, tell us about the response you are getting, especially from outside Kaba and Kogi State.
About
from
everything.
Your work. From your
wow,
work.
A lot of good response from our people. You see, I do tell people that society, the environment you are is not the problem.
Mm.
It's the way you package the work. What people really want is quality. Once you're able to bring out the quality and the package they want, people will, of course, there must be attention on you.
Mm.
And I think that's just what we're able to do. And we have got good response from indigenes and non-indigenes.
Mm.
At least from Kaba. We still go to Lagos to shoot weddings.
Mm.
From Kaba, we go to Ekiti, on those states.
Mm.
Very soon we are moving. Someone has invited us from Port Harcourt as well. And you can see these cities are places that has already good, what's it called, production managers or production studios over there. But yet, they see something good in whatever we do.
Okay.
And they see that we are up to the level of any society that we think we can match up with.
Mm.
So I think the push has just been that the response has just been that people are coming in from different spheres of life to patronize.
Well, we are looking at breaking barriers.
Yeah.
Before your rise to this present level, was there a time you had a challenge so huge that you almost gave up?
Not a time, so many times. No, about dreams. There's one enemy of dream in fulfillment of dream in life is the devil, and the devil never appear in person. He will always use people, people that you trust mostly, people that you entrust mostly. No, people that are very close to you that you think, okay, with this person I can move. He will use such people to discourage you, and it has happened severally.
Mm.
I do say to myself, I said, there's a time I was living with snake, not snake, physical snake, someone, a woman being, for more than 10 years plus, coaching, training them, and I was thinking, I'm making a team. You know now, when some of these guys, you know, fucked up, I was thinking that, okay, maybe that's the end of this career for me, because I thought I've invested my knowledge, you know, shared dreams with all of them, and I think, okay, we can move together now. But you know, they broke down. And this another time again, there was a time I had some of my gadgets in the studio. Some people boggled into the place when I was at 20. They took up an hard disk, a 500 gig hard disk that is filled up with so many works, pending jobs. No, then it feels like, hey, I should just run away and forget about this job. But shit, something God just say, come, guy. This thing is just strategy for the enemy to just bring it down. So, and I know something about devil, all about breaking barriers. You must not relent. You must not relent. If you are trying to peel up or to hit up a stone to get something from it, the stone will start first to throw back your hammer. But when you persist, it will get weak, and your watch will penetrate. So that's just my word.
Well, that's your me talking to Ross, that if you want to break barrier, then you must try not to relent in the pursuit of your dream. You have people that are under you, and of course there are also people who are watching now. Talk to them about how they can break barriers.
Well, I'm not a motivational speaker. I don't motivate people any longer. If you like, discourage. If you like, but I'll still say this anyway, is that don't relent. Don't relent. Especially those who are in Kaba. I think that's our main point right now.
Yes.
Those who are in this environment, that thought, Kaba, there's nothing here. There's nothing here. Let me move to Abuja. I tell you, Abuja is filled up already. Lagos is filled up with, in fact, people that are more better than you are there already. So Kaba is a very good starting point. Although the only problem we have in Kaba is what you have said, response and encouragement from people, and that's as just secondary, which we have been able to overcome now. Because of course right now we don't even yearn for clients anymore. People call us and we give them time. When you book for wedding now, we'll tell you, we ask your date first to see if we are, will be chanced or not. So which means that can be dealt with. So the first thing I would advise any youth is just to get yourself, as in just motivate yourself. Don't read motivational book, just motivate yourself by yourself, so that you now conclude and know that there's something I can get out from this compound, from this land. Then make sure you have your plans, just plan yourself. Once you plan yourself, and at the same time, if you want to meet me one on one, I will tell you what to now do to raise fund so that you get balance. Because one of the problems we have in our environment is this. No, they just want to make ends meet, just want money. But sometimes you have to ignore money. I ignore car and just focus on career and focus on your dream first. So later, money will come. We are not rich yet, but I know we are seeing this. So that's just my brief advice to the youth. You can grab anyway.
Okay.
I don't want to talk much.
No problem. What is the bigger picture for you? Let's say in the next 5 years, 10 years, where do we hope to see you?
I'll still be in Kaba.
Okay.
Yeah.
Doing.
I'm not planning to leave, or you know, some people, the only thing they just see that they just want to be rich and travel out of the country. No, we'll still be here together. We'll die here in this land. But something bigger, something magnificent will happen. I don't want to say it here. No, I don't know. So many people.
I don't hijack you.
I don't want to. Yeah. You know, we are very good at that in this environment. You know, so that's not even the reason. By the way, you know, I'm not done with my drawings. Before I say some things, before I'll be sure of whatever I want to do, I make sure I spend time. And you know, so many things to consider. They determine it. Now, environment here. One of the problems, I think I didn't mention that, is this. You know, for we small factory or few business, upcoming business this way, we lack hands, you know, capable hands that can work with us. You get it, but they are very scarce. When you see a person that is good in what you do, want to have his own. You get it, that now. So that is, so I have to be very calm first. Let us see how that goes.
Okay.
Because the more you open up for more business, the more people you will need.
Okay.
And one of the things that can kill the business is when you don't have more people to handle it, then it still go back to only you. You want to kill yourself, my brother. So, but at least in the next 10 years, I just know that something greater is going to happen by God's grace.
Okay.
I have plans.
Are you looking at other fields that you want to venture into?
Yeah. I'm diverting very soon.
Okay.
I'll be diverting out of media totally.
Really?
Very soon, yeah. Okay. For something, for some personal reason.
Okay.
Which I'll be discussing after 10 years again. Maybe when that succeeds, then you now ask me why I diverted to that, and it's still working.
And maybe by then the calling would have come.
The pastoral calling. Okay, maybe by then.
Perhaps it would have come.
Maybe by then.
And you may become perhaps an Okun evangelist.
Yeah, I'll be coming as, you know, to come and anoint and lay hands on you right then. Then after the program, I'll take my tithe. Even from Dave himself. So by then, no, everybody, include the manager, everybody, monthly.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be NTA manager, the NTA pastor then. But it's far from it anyway, but I'm coming up in a very good, as in, okay, in another dimension anyway.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah.
All right. Well, it's been Yomi in the studio, and he has a story that is quite inspiring. He started with challenges, and the things that would have been barriers for him actually became stepping stones. And that is why he's here in the studio today to tell us his story. The sky is his limit. And for you as well, the sky can be your limit. You may have your challenges today. But as you take steps and break the barriers, you will just discover that everything is possible. We'll be back next week. But before then, I want to say a very big thank you to Yomi.
Thank you, sir.
For sparing time out of his busy schedule to come and be part of this program. Yomi, thank you so much.
Mr. Jonathan.
We appreciate your time.
I appreciate you all. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. All right.